One outstanding result of the enfranchisement of women has been that party policies have had to become really practical, or else will fail in their appeal to women who are numerically the larger half of the electorate. They have had to be worked out not in terms of high-sounding theories, but of homes and wages and prices and the 101 problems of our daily lives. No policy which fails to do this can stand against the keen criticism of women voters. Every housewife has a direct interest in politics. She may not be a wage earner, and her work may not be limited to 8 hours a day. But as the co-partner in the home, her concern is with the family budget. She is the Chancellor of the Exchequer, who has to plan not a yearly, but a weekly budget, and in the majority of cases has to make, not like Mr. Churchill, a lot go a little way, but a little go a long way. In the household where every shilling counts, a penny here and a penny there on articles of everyday use will soon mount up to a sufficient sum to make all the difference between just enough and just too little. That margin has, in any case, been greatly narrowed since the war. For now, we have to spend £1.13 to get what we used to buy for £1. Any government which, in times of peace, spends an increased sum on armament, which taxes household necessities, which gives subsidies to special industries at the expense of all, must put an additional tax on the taxpayer and increase the difficulties of the family budget. The Liberal Party, by its policy of peace, by wise spending and of free trade, will help the housewife in her task of making a small income meet large demands. First and foremost, the Liberal Party will work for peace. We are still spending £6 million more on armaments than in 1924. Out of every pound raised by taxation, 14 shillings represents the cost of wars, present, past, and future. 6 shillings only is spent on social services. The Conservative Party proclaims its desire for peace, but prepares for war. The Liberal Party will put its principles into practice. It will strengthen the League of Nations. It will immediately reduce armaments. It will sweep away artificial tariff barriers, which are a very real hindrance to international understanding. Secondly, the Liberal Party is prepared to face the problem of unemployment. It is a question which closely affects women, for while men look upon it in terms of lost wages, of reduced exports and imports, and of loss of national wealth, women see it in terms of shortages in the home. By turning depression into prosperity, the Liberal Party will not only relieve the burden of unemployment, which the whole nation has to bear in high taxation, but also create national wealth from which everyone will benefit. By economy, by the solution of the unemployment problem, by a return to free trade, the Liberal Party will reduce the cost of living. By its policy for peace and for social welfare, it will ensure to every family that wider, fuller, individual life for which liberalism stands today.